If there's two things I know about the universe, it's that it's big and there's a lot of it. So much, in fact, that we didn't know where half of it was until recently. Now, before you get your hopes up, I'm not talking about dark matter or dark energy, which combined make up over 95% of the universe. I know you're all as antsy as I am to find out what dark matter and dark energy really are, but that mystery remains unsolved. No, I'm talking about plain old baryonic matter, like you and me and everything we know. The stuff that makes up less than 5% of the universe. Turns out, we couldn't even track that stuff down. That's not to say we didn't have a pretty good idea of where it was. See, the matter we could account for was where you'd expect it to be, bundled up in 2 trillion galaxies, each with an average of hundreds of billions of stars across the observable universe. In between those galaxies, we think, are filaments of dark matter, linking them together in a mind-breakingly huge cosmic web. We suspected the gravity of that dark matter also attracted regular matter too, which had been turned into plasma after ultraviolet radiation from early stars separated atoms from their electrons. The plasma is what's known as the WHIM, or warm-hot intergalactic medium. For a long time, the problem was we couldn't see the WHIM, it was just too hard to detect. Until two separate teams found it using the Sunyaev-Zeldovich effect. When photons pass through a plasma, they get shifted to a slightly higher energy level. The effect is very tiny though, so the teams took data from hundreds of thousands to a million pairs of galaxies they figured would be connected by the WHIM and stacked them up until the effect was noticeable. Just like that, they found half the baryonic matter in the universe and more evidence of a dark matter web. So, 5% down, 95% to go. We're getting closer, guys. If you like this video, subscribe so you don't miss more cool science matters. We keep coming up with new ways to look for dark matter, like with black holes and gravitational waves. Check out the deets here. By the way, when we say baryonic matter, technically electrons don't count because they're leptons, but astronomers lump them in with protons and neutrons to make things simpler. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time on Seeker.